Well, these multi-stem stem cells are derived from human bone marrow, and so they're very easy to isolate. They're very easy to grow up. They're very safe in other diseases. They've been used in patients with heart attack and graft-versus-host disease, and they are very effective in animal models. The other thing I like about them is that they're a universal solution. In other words, they do not have to be tissue matched to the patient. So when a patient comes in, you can grab these literally off the shelf, thaw them out, and then administer them to the patient, and they're given intravenously. The advantage of a restorative treatment, a recovery drug, or recovery stem cell like multi-stem is that the time window we're looking at is 24 hours to 36 hours after the stroke. So by that time, almost everybody with a stroke has made it to the hospital. So it's nice to have a treatment that you can give that late. Interestingly, you know, we thought initially these stem cells would go to the brain and develop into neurons and nerve cells. They don't really do that. In fact, they go to the brain, but they don't stay long. And their major effect is kind of transient on the brain, but probably more persistent on the immune organs of the body. And so we think the stem cells kind of go in there and almost act as referees. They kind of quiet these immune cells down and let the neurons recover. So at GHSU here, we did a lot of the preclinical work with these cells. We test them in animal models, you know, going back 6-7 years. And we had some NIH funding, and a lot of our data was used for the FDA approval to allow us to use these. And so we were actually the first site that was up and enrolling. I think we enrolled the second patient in this trial. And so we're one of multiple sites enrolling. I think at the end of the trial, we'll know about their safety. So far, so good. We'll know that they're feasible. We'll know that they're well tolerated. And we'll have some hint that we call efficacy. And that's what a phase two trial does. It really gives you information to know if there's any evidence of activity and then how big the next trial has to be to determine efficacy. The FDA usually requires you to do a trial that's kind of a slam dunk on efficacy. So it has to be a larger trial. And so that's what this trial really is. It's really to get us to the definitive trial.